This record, As the Palaces Burn, was probably the most physically exhausting, nerve-wracking record to make.
It was time to move on to a different sound.
And this is going to be a very, very special record. And for those people on the fence, this is going to certainly define their decision one way or the other. Really, my dream was at the time to get this guy Devin Townsend in.
Someone gave me a call and said, there's this band that's interested in using you, and we'd like to send you their disc. And I remember thinking to myself, I don't know if they're very good, but I'll do it. We're at the studio, we roll in, and it's this board. This channel doesn't work. Watch out for this one. Here, get the cat off of it.
We had never really worked with somebody who would try to lend a vision to one of our projects.
My guys didn't want anybody producing them. It burned him out really hard.
And there's all this rhetoric about Randy. He's gonna show up drunk. He's going to be a total liability. And I said, you know, the band has elected me to tell you, you're not allowed to drink.
I understand being bad mentally.
I don't want to say a tense time. We knew what we had on our hands and we wanted to, you know, absolutely push it.
The whole process of making Palaces made us better players on our instruments with Devin Townsend hanging over our shoulder.
Devin was pushing Willie so hard, I remember him coming out of the room and kind of almost tearing up. Gets to the end, we know we don't have time to mix it, we don't have time to master it.
If I try and mix this, it's gonna kill me.
Considering that he was stuck on this antiquated recording software, when we finally got, you know, started getting the mixes back, it was just like, what happened?
I was like, oh, this sounds horrible, man.
That record took on a life of its own. So the way it sounds is the way it sounds. It just became part of the personality of the record.
We are retooling As the Palaces Burn, which is great.
I think the potential of the record is still sitting there.
They really felt strongly that the best way to approach this whole process was to take the original, find the original recordings from Richmond, Virginia. I got a broken hard drive and about 200 something CDRs. I just think it'll be exciting for people to rediscover a record that they've always loved.
I have the impression that this record is not going to sound like any other record, but it's going to be important because of that.
I'm proud of some of the lyrics Mark and I wrote on that, and I'm proud of some of the music too. There's some kick-ass songs on there.
It stands the test of time.
It's still my favorite record that we've done.
It sounds like Palaces, you know?